As a tiny child, there is just beingness.
Consciousness without an object is. Before objects were, consciousness without an object is. Though objects seem to exist, consciousness without an object is. When objects vanish, yet remaining through all unaffected, consciousness without an object is. Outside of consciousness without an object, nothing is. Within the bosom of consciousness without an object lies the power of awareness that projects objects. When objects are projected, the power of awareness as subject is presupposed. Yet consciousness without an object remains unchanged. When consciousness of objects is born, then, likewise, consciousness of absence of objects arises. Consciousness of objects is the universe. Consciousness of absence of objects is nirvana. Within consciousness without an object lie both the universe and nirvana, yet to consciousness without an object, these two are the same. Thank you. Within consciousness without an object lies the seed of time. When awareness cognizes time, then knowledge of timelessness is born. To be aware of time is to be aware of the universe. And to be aware of the universe is to be aware of time. To realize timelessness is to attain nirvana. But for consciousness without an object, there is no difference between time and timelessness. Within consciousness without an object lies the seed of the world containing space. When awareness cognizes the world containing space, then knowledge of the spatial void is born. To be aware of the world containing space is to be aware of the universe of objects. To be aware of the world containing space is to be aware of the universe of objects. realize the spatial void is to awaken to nirvanic consciousness. But for consciousness without an object, there is no difference between the world containing space and the spatial void. Within consciousness without an object lies the seed of law. When consciousness of object is born, the law is invoked as a force tending ever toward equilibrium. All objects exist as tensions within consciousness without an object that tend ever to flow into their own complements or others. The ultimate effect of the flow of all objects into their complements is mutual cancellation, in complete equilibrium. Consciousness of the field of tensions is the universe. Consciousness of equilibrium is nirvana. But for consciousness without an object, there is neither tension nor equilibrium. The state of tensions is the state of ever becoming. Ever becoming is endless dying. So the state of consciousness of objects is a state of ever-renewing promises that pass into death at the moment of fulfillment. Thus, when consciousness is attached to objects, the agony of birth and death never ceases. Thank you. in the state of equilibrium where birth cancels death, the deathless bliss of nirvana is realized. But consciousness without an object is neither agony nor bliss. Out of the great void, which is consciousness without an object, the universe is creatively projected. The universe as experienced is the created negation that ever resists. The creative act is bliss. The resistance, unending pain. Endless resistance is the universe of experience. Agony of crucifixion. Ceaseless creativeness is nirvana. The bliss beyond human conceiving. Ceaseless creativeness is nirvana. The bliss beyond human conceiving. But for consciousness without an object, there is neither creativeness nor resistance. Ever becoming and ever ceasing to be are endless action. When ever becoming cancels the ever ceasing to be, then rest is realized. ceaseless action is the universe. Unending rest is nirvana. But consciousness without an object is neither action nor rest. When consciousness is attached to objects, it is restricted through the forms imposed by the world containing space, by time, and by law. When consciousness is disengaged from objects, liberation from the forms of the world containing space, of time, and of law is attained. Attachment to objects is consciousness bound within the universe. Liberation from such attachment is the state of unlimited nirvanic freedom. But consciousness without an object is neither bondage nor freedom. Consciousness without an object may be symbolized by a space. That is unaffected by the presence or absence of objects. For which there is neither time nor timelessness. Neither a world containing space nor a spatial void. neither tension nor equilibrium. Neither resistance nor creativeness. Neither agony nor bliss. Neither action nor rest. And neither restriction nor freedom. As the great space is not to be identified with the universe, so neither is it to be identified with any self. As the great space is not to be identified with the universe, so neither is it to be identified with any self. The great space is not God. But the comprehender of all gods. As well as of all lesser creatures. Thank you. great space or consciousness without an object? Is the soul reality? Upon which all objects and all selves depend and derive their existence. Comprehends both the path of the universe and the path of nirvana. Beside the great space, there is none other. Beside the great space, there is none other. Beside the great space, there is none other. the only absolutely perfect word. Is absolute silence.